Hi yogis, welcome to my practice today. My name is Claire and today we're going to be working through a quick evening flow, opening out those areas of the body that have been restricted through working at a desk or a laptop or whatever you do, hunched over. So instead of being all hunched and squashed before we go to bed, we're just going to release any tension, open out some areas that have been compressed and relax into our evenings. This can be done any time of day, of course, but it's particularly good for when you finish work, especially for any of you that are in lockdown at the moment, which is when this video was filmed. I'm keeping a jumper on because I like to be cosy whilst I work through this practice, and this is the kind of thing I do in the evening, sometimes just before I get into bed. So without further ado, we're going to make a start, making a start in child's pose at the bottom of the mat. So you can take child's either with your knees together or your knees apart. If you want to bring the floor up to you, then you can use a cushion or a block just under your bottom, just to bring that floor closer to you to relieve any tension on the lower back. So I like to walk my hands out and push my hips back to my heels for my child's, keeping the length in my arms and stretch under my armpits before I just melt my chest towards the floor and my forehead too. Whilst you're in that position, I invite you to close down your eyes, and if you would like to set an intention or a theme for your practice, it's the perfect time to do it. You can go with a mantra, or for me, I just like to use an intention of let go. So just saying that as I breathe, inhaling the word let and exhaling the word go. Perfectly good for in the evening when you just want to let go of your day. Any stored up tension, stress, just let that go now. Let yourself arrive on the mat, really feeling the release in your lower back, your hips, your shoulders, your neck. Breathing here, feeling nice and warm and cozy as we walk our hands forwards, coming up into tabletop, so our hips are over our heels. Let's walk our hands forward. If you've got long arms like me, your hands are probably going to reach the top of the mat at this point. And then when you go no further with your arms, keeping them nice and straight, elbows looking towards each other, stretching down your armpits, heart melting towards the floor as far as you can go. If you can go as far as me, then your chin might reach the mat, but that's not important. This is a stretch down your back, keeping your hips above your knees, and then melting the heart towards the floor. Try not to go too far back or banana your back, so you're getting a kind of banana shape there. That's wrong. You want a nice straight spine. Only when it's straight, let the heart melt towards the floor. Stretch all the way along your armpits, shoulders away from your ears, trying to pull your shoulder blades apart from each other. On your next inhale, meet me back in that tabletop position, hands under your shoulders, hands about shoulder width apart, knees hip width apart here. Let's inhale our left hand, all five fingertips pointing towards the ceiling, and exhale, posting that hand to the space between your right hand and your right knee. Left shoulder, left cheek finds the mat, thread the needle. Can walk your right hand out straight if you want. Make sure your hips are equal and even here, not sinking towards one side. If you want to go to the full extent of this posture, windmill your arm all the way around and tuck your right hand in your left hip crease. If that's too much, just stay with your right hand out in front of you. Inhale, walking the hand back under your shoulder. Left hand, all five fingertips towards the sky. Left hand finds the mat next to right hand. Meet me back in tabletop here. Inhale on the other side. So right hand, all five fingertips towards the sky. Right hand posts that space between left hand and left knee. Walk left hand out if you want to. Check your hips are equal over your knees. Back isn't too arched. Abs slightly turned on and engaged here. Inhale, walk that left hand forward. Swing that right hand all the way up. Meet me back in the tabletop position here. Lovely. Back nice and straight, not too round. Making any adjustments to your clothes, your t-shirt, anything you need to here. And let's just wiggle our hips. Drawing a circle or a figure of eight or whatever feels comfortable for you here. You can keep your eyes closed if that feels good. Just rolling around. Meet me in a moment of stillness here as we move forwards. Inhaling, our heart shines forwards to the top of the mat. Exhale, rounding that spine, chin dips. two more times, inhaling, exhale round, one more time, inhale, exhale round. If you can do this with your eyes closed, that's really comforting for the evening. Meet me back in that tabletop position, walking your hands back towards your knees, coming up so your whole torso and body and shoulders are above your knees now. As inhale, sweeping the arms up, exhale, tucking your hands on your bottom, fingertips pointing down, just pushing your hips forwards, a very, very slight back bend here, shoulder blades pulling towards each other, chest nice and open. Breathing, and exhale, back into all fours, tabletop, wiggling those hips, and inhale, just stepping your right foot to the space in between your hands, very low lunge here, and then all we're going to do is stretch out that left hip flexor, so your foot might need to just heel toe a little bit further forwards. I'm really feeling that length in that left hip flexor, stretching that out after it's been squashed all day. Exhale, straighten right leg, half splits. We're only going to do this once today because we don't want to get too hot in the evening. Meet me back in tabletop and then do that on the other side. So left hand space in between, left foot space in between your hands. Maybe walking your right knee back a little bit in space. If it feels uncomfortable, curl your mat up and place your foot, your right knee on the mat. Inhaling here, stretching out that right hip flexor. Exhale back, half splits. Bringing your right, so your left toes towards your nose if you can, keeping that length in your spine. Lovely. Okay, let's go back into the tabletop position on an inhale. Wiggle out that lower back again. Crossing your legs behind you if that's comfortable. Rolling over your feet as we find bound angle pose. I'll move so you can see me. So we want the soles of our feet pressing together, knees apart. So from your toes to your knees to your hips, we want a nice diamond shape. Doesn't matter if your heels are close to your bottom or far away, whatever feels comfortable. Flap your legs like a butterfly wings here. Inhaling up, open that chest. And exhale, I'm going to encourage you to round your spine this time. Normally in yoga, we try not to round our spine if it's not in the right position. Often with this one, we want to keep a nice straight spine and encourage our chin to go past our toes. But today we're going to relax our spine and our neck. So dip your chin towards your chest. Feeling that length for the whole spinal column here. Curving, releasing tension in your neck. Wiggle your jaw if you can. Flutter your eyes up and down. Make some funny faces, it doesn't matter, nobody can see you. Really releasing any tension in your jaw. Staying here for two more breaths with your eyes closed. And then when you're ready, meet me back seated with your soles of your feet on the floor, your knees bent, your chest pressing against your knees, your belly button to some compression between your stomach and your thighs. Hands up and let's roll all the way down, vertebrae by vertebrae. So the whole spine is supported by the mat. Bringing your right knee to your chest, revolving your right knee out. Your right ankle is on your left knee, but the bony bit of your ankle, just make sure that's not pressing against your thigh, that's just come away a little bit. Foot and knee in line, stay here if this is comfortable, reclined pigeon again, stretching out those hip flexors. If you want to go further, bring your knee towards your chest, that's your left knee. If you want to go even further, you can straighten your leg, or the alternative is to grab hold of that left calf with both hands. And pulling your bent leg towards you, you'll really feel that stretch in your right hip flexor. Breathing here. One more deep breath. Sighing out any tension. We're going to try and put this right foot on the floor by rotating our hips over to create a supine twist. That might be too much for some of you because it's really important that both your shoulder blades stay on the mat. So if you prefer, just untuck that leg and then just put both knees on top of each other here. If you can't put your knees on top of each other, again, it's fine to have a block here. Supine twist. Squeezing out any tension, almost rinsing your organs. One more breath. meet me back in that bent leg position. Let's do that on the other side. So bringing left knee towards chest, rotating it out. Left ankle finds right knee just below the knee though. And making sure the bony bit of the ankle isn't pressing against your right thigh. Stay here if that's enough. If not, bring your knee towards your chest. Grab that calf if you want to. Making sure that all your spine is pressed against the mat. That whole posterior chain feeling supported. And breathe. Really feeling that nice opening in your hips. Back feeling supported and straight. And when you're ready, let's twist over to the other side. So we're twisting towards the right. So my left foot is finding the mat here. My right leg is also finding the floor. If that's too much, stacking your knees on top of each other. And if you want to, look towards your left. Feeling that twist in your neck. Lovely. Breathing in, bringing your knees towards your chest. Peace fingers around your big toes. Happy baby, rock back and forth. Little spinal massage here. Both soles of the feet find the mat again, making sure your fingertips can tickle the backs of your feet, your heels. Hands on the floor, palms down. Bringing your hips towards the sky, pushing your knees backwards and your chest forwards. See if you can nuzzle and shimmy your shoulders under. If you want to go really far, clasping your hands and using the clasp of your hands and your forearms to push you further into this bridge pose. If this is far too much for you, just put a block under your hips and take supported bridge here. If you've got it in your practice and you want to do it, I invite you to take a wheel. I don't tend to do that. Making sure all four corners of your feet are pressing down into the mat. Your chest really shining towards your chin. You almost want to get in a position where you can't see your ribs. Knees pushing back. Unlock your hands, shimmy your shoulders back out. Rolling down vertebrae by vertebrae. Let the energy settle. Bring your knees up to your chest when it has. Give yourself a cuddle. Shining the soles of your feet towards the ceiling now in waterfall pose. If you've got shoulder stand and you want to take that and that's in your practice, do feel free. I'm taking a more restorative version here. I'm just going to wriggle out my ankles, neglected part of the practice. One way and then the other. I'm now going to imagine almost pushing the ceiling away with the soles of my feet. Also making sure my abs are pulled in, the whole part of my lower spine is feeling flat to the floor. And then just relax when you can. If you want to take this with your legs up against the wall, you can do that. You can stop the video here and just take Shavasana, our relaxation pose like this, that's also fine. Or if you just want to pause the video and stay here for as long as you feel comfortable and then pick back up again, also fine. Your practice. Okay, when you're ready, bringing your knees back to your chest again, giving yourself a hug. We're going to rock and roll on our spine. All the way up. All the way back. It's a really good free spinal massage just to end the practice with. Do this as many times as you want. No one can see you. I'm sure you can laugh at me if you find this funny, but I quite enjoy this. And when you're ready, come back up to that bound angle position. So I'm going to take my relaxation pose like this tonight. If you want to though, you can just take this cross-legged, or if you really prefer, just lie down on your mat. Whatever feels comfortable as we just wind down, really enjoying that openness we've created in our body. Closing our eyes. If you're in Shavasana, which is corpse pose, just lying flat on the mat with your palms shining upwards. Please do stay here as long as possible. Light a candle, put a warm jumper on, anything that feels comfortable. And I'm going to leave you here, but I invite you to stay as long as you can. You really deserve it. Just take some relaxation, some really long breaths, thinking back to that intention we set of let go. Breathing in with the word let, pausing, exhaling the word go, and just give yourself some time to reflect. Some time to soak up all the benefits we've created in our body. really winding down and settling down. As I say goodbye and thank you for joining me in the practice today, join me again for another practice soon. Thank you very much, yogis.